Hello everyone, in the previous part of the video, we have discussed about the derivation for finding expression for kinetic energy and also expression for potential energy. So in this video, we will discuss about the law of conservation of energy and the power. The law of conservation of energy states that energy can neither be created nor destroyed, but can be converted from one form to another. So it means that the total energy will remain fixed, but that energy may transform from one form of energy into another form of energy. So now let us discuss about an activity where the total mechanical energy remains fixed. Mechanical energy means sum of kinetic energy and potential energy, but there we can see that the potential energy will change into kinetic energy. So we have already derived an expression for kinetic energy and potential energy. So which is, kinetic energy is half mv square and potential energy is mgh. So this kinetic energy depends on mass and velocity. Potential energy depends on mass, acceleration due to gravity and height from the ground. In this activity, let us consider a ball which is at a height capital S from the ground, and initially the ball is at rest so that the velocity is zero, and from the expression for kinetic energy, if the velocity is zero, kinetic energy is zero. So the ball has zero kinetic energy and the potential energy will be given by mg capital S because the ball is at capital S height from the ground. Now consider the second case where the ball is falling from the height. So in this case, the velocity is not zero and the ball is at a height smaller than the previous height. So let me represent the height by small h. And at this position, the ball possesses both kinetic energy as well as potential energy, which is given by this expression. And now consider the third case where the ball is about to reach the ground. So the height of the ball from the ground is zero. So if h is zero, then the potential energy will be zero, and before reaching the ground, the kinetic energy of the ball will be maximum because the velocity is maximum before reaching the ground. So that the expression for kinetic energy and potential energy is this. Now here, if we add the kinetic energy and potential energy in this case, and kinetic energy, potential energy if we add for the second case, and similarly if we add kinetic energy and potential energy for the third case, then it will be same in all the three cases. Only the thing that is happened here is, for the first case, the ball has only potential energy. In the second case, the ball has both kinetic energy and potential energy, and in the third case, the ball has only kinetic energy. So from first case to second case, the part of potential energy has been converted into kinetic energy. And in the last case, all the potential energy that the ball possesses has been converted fully to kinetic energy. So this is how the energy transforms from one form to another. So here the energy has transformed from potential energy to kinetic energy, but the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy will remain fixed. So this is the law of conservation of energy. From the activity, we came to know that the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy of the object be same at all the points, so that we can write sum of potential energy plus kinetic energy equals to constant. Hence, during the free fall of an object, the decrease in potential energy at any point in its path appears as an equal amount of increase in kinetic energy. In this case, potential energy is transformed into kinetic energy. So this I have already explained. And mechanical energy is the sum of kinetic and potential energy. Now we define the term power Power is defined as rate of doing work. And the formula related to the power is work done divided by time. This power is calculated in SI unit called watt. And the power is said to be 1 watt when 1 joule work is done in 1 second. So when the work done is 1 joule and the time taken is 1 second, then the power is 1 watt. Now we discuss about the commercial unit of energy. It is a bigger unit of energy which is used for commercial purpose. The bigger unit of energy is called kilowatt hour. So here is a picture of energy meter which is installed in each and every house consuming electricity. So this energy meter, it calculates the amount of energy used by a certain house. And if you look at carefully in the display of energy meter, then you will see like this KWH, so which means kilowatt hour. Electrical energy used during a month is expressed in terms of units. Unit means the number here which is displayed. It is 6.5. So it means that the power consumption is 6.5 unit. So here 1 unit means 1 kilowatt hour. So here 6.5 kilowatt hour.